On Masters of Spin this morning, how Victorians are being given a bad rap for something that's not their fault. The so-called second wave of COVID-19 infections in Melbourne has seen Victorians banned from entering other states without a permit. And those who got through are being told to go back.
You would know that you are potentially a risk to the community of New South Wales. Please go home as soon as is reasonably practicable. Go home. If you can, go home. Go back to Victoria and go back to your area and comply with your own government's laws.
That is the New South Wales Health Minister there, Brad Hazzard. And our Masters of Spin are here this morning, advertising and marketing experts Matthew Bywater and Dee Madigan. Matt, he was blunt, but do we need blunt right now? Is blunt the way to go?
Yeah, blunt, direct is another way of putting it. But yeah, it's important. And I think I really like what Nick Coatworth said during the week. And he said that blame game is bad public policy, public health policy. And I think we need to take that in mind, is that we need to sit down and just listen to what the experts are saying, listen to what the politicians are saying, pay attention and not get too much on the blame game.
We're holding our breath, of course, to see how it plays out across the rest of the country. But Dee, mud sticks. Could Victorians, do you think, end up being, you know, I guess, vilified for years to come as the rest of Australia looks at shutting them out?
Look, I hope not. I saw some really horrible things yesterday where even a couple of journalists were using the phrase the Melbourne virus. It's like, come on, guys, there but for the grace of God go all of us. And I suspect New South Wales, given that plane landed the other day, you know, with people on there and Victorians have been in New South Wales, New South Wales will be there, I think, soon enough anyway. So, you know, demonising one part of Australia is unhelpful.
OK, well, let's move on now. And it seemed like a bit of a joke at the time. It still does, really. Rapper Kanye West actually seems serious about running for president this year, saying he's done with his mate Donald Trump. In a Rambling magazine interview, he says it's not too late to get on November's ballot paper. He talked about being against vaccines, claimed that there's a conspiracy to microchip people, and listed his advisors as his wife, Kim Kardashian. Terrific. And businessman Elon Musk, Matthew... What do you think? I mean, we cannot ever write off any candidate, can we? We know that.
Yeah.
And in America, the power of celebrity is strong.
Celebrity is huge. This goes back to the 1920s when Warren Harding first got elected by basically Hollywood support. And if you look at the last election in 2016, if you put together the celebrities that supported Hillary Clinton versus the ones that supported Trump, you put their Twitter followers together combined, it was like 195 million versus about 20 million. And you know, with celebrities, you know, with one in five advertisements in the world featuring a celebrity, they're very, very important because we'd like to not only follow celebrities, we actually like to actually follow what they follow. So this is huge.
And yeah, with the upheaval in America at the moment, there might be a lot of people just looking to try and break the system. Dee, he's calling his party the birthday party because when he wins, of course, it will be everyone's birthday. Let's break it down. Do you actually think he might have any semblance of a chance?
No, but my theory is this. He's always been a Trump supporter. Mm. If he starts his own party, the Democrats need the black vote. If he starts his own party and takes a good percentage of the black vote away from the Democrats, he won't win. He'll never win. That's fine. It means the Democrats don't win either, and guess who does?
Trump. So do you think... So do you spot a conspiracy in here?
I'm not much of a conspiracy theorist, but on this one, absolutely, 100%. He has always been Trump.
Yeah.
And this is the only way that Trump can win. I think it's a dangerous and a smart play.
Yes, we haven't heard him really hit out at Trump, just saying, I'm done with him. All right, now finally, sense of normality is returning to the suburbs. Who knows for how long, though. Bunnings bringing back the weekend sausage sizzle. Matt... Is that good thing?
That's great. It's good for everyone. It's good for the local sports club who wants to raise funds. It's good for the people who have to go to Bunnings and want a little sausage sandwich on the way in. It's good for the Bunnings brand. I mean, this is actually part of the... But the fact is, it's become part of the Bunnings brand, actually having that sausage sizzle there and having that community support as well. So it's great.
Whoever started that sausage sizzle for
genius.
Bunnings...
Genius.
Absolute
so
genius.
Simple. All right, thank you both. Dee, Matthew, great to see you.
You too.